Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ.
Why is it when you need a miracle, it doesn't happen, but when you least expect it, it happens?
You are married. You have challenges in your relationship, but your spouse is unwilling to accede to any counseling. Is divorce an option?
How does a parent handle a promiscuous child?
What are considered the do's and don'ts of a born-again couple who is not yet married?
There are always more questions than answers. So here is Apostle Gemma.
Grace and peace to you. Welcome to Ask Pastor Gemma. In the event that you're a first-time viewer, I thank you for taking the time to be with me this afternoon. You would want to stay and view simply because I am going to start dealing with something that everybody would have experienced. And the theme of what I'll be sharing will be why God's answers to our whys. And I'm sure that at some point you will say, why God, why did this happen to me? Why did you allow it to happen? Why didn't you stop it? And it seems as though at times God is silent, he doesn't say anything. But I'm coming to you today to tell you that God actually responds to your why questions. And sometimes we say they are dead-end questions. They're not always dead-end questions. See answers, so you have to stay to get some of the answers to or why God questions. If you're viewing me for the first time, my name is Gemma Duncan. I'm married to Apostle Vivian Duncan. And together we pastor Divine Destiny Worship Center. Our headquarters is in Diego Martin on the Diego Martin Main Road opposite Sardonyx Drive. We have branches in Sangre Grande, in Chaguanas, Faisabad. There's a branch in Tobago and one in Antigua. The Rio Claro branch is now fully online. Our services are in person on Sunday mornings. Now you can come in person or you can take us online. And then we have the weekly services, Thursday evening at 7, Friday evening at 7. And those two are fully online. The administrative office is opened Monday to Thursday from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. And the business center from Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Please join us for these two great sessions. Call our numbers. Today we continue our little discussion on God's response to a why question. And we looked at the first one where God is saying, trust me. Response number two is, so you will grow. I pray that you will be blessed by it and encouraged, and it will bring understanding to you as to the season that you are at in your quest for understanding how God works with you. God bless you.
As for God, the psalmist says, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord is tried. He's a buckler to all those that trust him. As for God, his way is perfect. Now remember he said to us, my ways are higher than yours. You don't quite understand my ways. But his way is perfect. The word of the Lord is tried. Well, tried means tested and found true.
Mm-hmm.
For he is a buckler. And a buckler means he holds you. You know, it strengthens you. He buttresses you for those that trust in him. So we're going into number two. So you will grow. And you may say, so you can't find the next way for me to grow. Well, that's one of his ways for allowing growth and maturity to come. James chapter 1, verse 2 to 4, and we will look at it in the usual versions. James chapter 1. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith will get patience. But let patience have a perfect work, that he may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. Let's look at the Amplified. Consider it holy joy for my brethren, whenever you are enveloped in or encounter trials of any sort, or fall into various temptations. No, I mean, James himself, that's a little, the way he put it, that's not easy to do, but that's what he's saying that we should do. Verse 3. Be assured and understand that the trial and proving of your faith bring out endurance and steadfastness and patience. Verse 4. But let endurance and steadfastness and patience have full play and do a thorough work, so that you may be people perfectly and fully developed with no defects, lacking nothing. So there is a reason for trials. There are reasons for certain experiences that may seem to be negative to us, but God is working something in us. He's maturing us. And the end of it is that we'll be fully developed with no defects, lacking nothing. There are some characteristics that God will want to instill in us that could come in no other way than by trials and difficulties.
That's true.
There's no other way that it's going to happen. It happen. Because the Bible says that Jesus and all learned obedience by the things he suffered. And he was our example. Well, he is our example. Let's look at NIV, and then we'll go to the Amplified. And then if you want to comment.
That was the Amplified.
Message, sorry.
Message, right.
Right. Consider pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. Perseverance must finish its work so that you may become mature and complete, not lacking anything. Absolutely important. Look at the NIV. What happens? Because remember, you start over trials, and then you come with perseverance, and perseverance must complete its work. When we wiggle out and fight God and struggle with God, sometimes he would just let us slip out of his hand because we're fighting him. And the work that God wants to do with us may not be complete. The level of maturity that God will want to bring into us will not happen. Guess what? You already know what the scenario is. God doesn't skip classes. So if I'm going through something, and as that happened to me time and time again, I'm protesting, I'm quarreling, you're crying, you're carrying, badgering God. And God say, all right, but there is a level that I want to take you with, you know, the place of maturity that I want to carry you. If you don't allow this particular trial or experience, it's not going to be finished. And God don't like force ripe fruit, like force ripe mango, it's unpleasant to the taste. But he says, that perseverance must finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. Let's go to the message, and then if Apostle Vivian has a comment, we'll take it. Consider it a shared gift, friends, when tests and challenges come at you from all sides. Wow. You know that under pressure, your faith life is forced into the open and shows its true colors. Verse 4. So don't try to get out of anything prematurely. Let it do its work so you become mature and well developed, not deficient in any way.
The scenario I'm seeing here is going to a gym for exercise. You know, all the machines, all the exercises that they give is built on a principle of resistance, building muscles, resistance toning muscles, resistance building stamina. In other words, when situations show up that, well, when the oil boil down is negative pressure then against you, resisting your desire to go forward, resisting God's plan for us to go forward. Know that it's for building spiritual, social, mental, psychological muscles, because the maturing of muscles are supposed to be commensurate with the maturing of age, the maturing of your physical body. So that's why the whole question of understanding that God could use your failure. In fact, today this Lord dropped this word on me. God will use your past to your advantage in your future, whereas the enemy wants to use your past to your disadvantage in your future. Hence, we need to forgive our abusers. Do you know that's part of the gym work? To build our character, part of our gym work is to forgive people. Oh gosh, but person, that's so hard. Why God want me to forgive them? And just come back. And when you go to the gym, one exercise on the treadmill or the whatever they call those things doesn't build all your muscles the way, you know? When you go back the next,
and they added more weight, because at first it's so painful and uncomfortable.
That's
and
right.
And then you feel that you conquer, and you say good, because now you start to exercise and you're not feeling the pain.
That's right.
And then they add more
That's
weight.
Right. And especially the gym instructor who you could have spoken to, and he or she would kind of ease you, didn't come today. They put a brand new one. And you hear how the gym that he works in oversaw, and people there that listen, they talk about the pain, and this is the guy that has come. And that's what God wants to do with us. So every situation that shows up, it's reflected in that passage we read in Romans chapter 8 as well. In all of these things, we are what? More than conqueror. You cannot be a conqueror unless you fight. Let's just stand up and fight. And sometimes you'll get some blows, but at the end of the day, the victory is yours.
Looking back at my life,
mm-hmm.
there are a number of things as a young person I attempted. And anytime it became challenging, I would leap walk away.
Mm-hmm.
And looking back, I regret, because there were certain skills that I could have acquired,
mm-hmm.
and I didn't, because the going got rough.
Right.
I remember, I don't know how it happened, but, well, you know, you're doing a little PE, and I don't know if the coach in school, in secondary school, I was always bigger than the average student in the class and so on, big-bodied, and they asked me to consider doing discus and shot put.
Gosh,
discus javelin.
I could have been the Olympics boy.
Look. And, the heavy one?
The shot put.
Shot put. And discus and so on.
Mm.
And I mean, so you know, at first I say cool. When I realized these excruciating exercises that you had to do before you even, because you have to prepare your arm to throw,
yes,
and that kind of thing, not just because you're big and strong.
That's
because
right.
I had a friend, I mean, she was really skinny, and I make a joke that say I insulting the girl and telling how mager she was, and she say it's only yam and cassava. She say all that fat you have there, that is yam and cassava.
Oh,
well,
Jesus.
Listen to me, I keep quiet for the rest of my days, yes. You know. And and when I realized how much, by the time I was the first set of training started, I used to go home, and I was from San Fernando, I had to travel on the bus. Of course, you're late, you're alone, you're tired. Since, I mean, remember the buses pick up, it was dark, while in the dark. Mm-hmm. And then I stay back now to do this training. All over your hurting you. By the time you reach home, that hour, you
have to nobody helping you.
And that kind of a thing. And get ready to wake up in the night again, in the dark again, to go to school. I just decided this is just too much. Right? And perhaps there was potential there. Perhaps the coach saw something in me and I didn't want to persevere. And there are times when God will allow certain things, and it was very painful. I was not disciplined. I mean, I never used to exercise in that kind of manner. And I mean, it wasn't just hand. He was exercising my entire body, my body. You're going to be a short put runner at this, during this course, but you have to run around
that's
the field.
Right. That's
and all that kind of thing. And you have to do all kind of training, stomach training and so on. So there are men, it's not just training, right? But when I realized how uncomfortable, how painful it was, of course, I didn't have any kind of encouragement from home. Papa didn't even know what I was doing. He just knew I come home late and you stay back because the coach are there for some sports thing. And, you know, there was nobody to kind of tell you that there may have been some kind of a future in that particular activity and you had to go through it. I'm just saying to you, like in the natural, as a child, if you are a youngster, there are some things that you're doing now that are very challenging. They may be physically painful. If you have the potential to be an athlete or something like that, a lot of discipline, or you have to do piano lessons, which kind of hurts your finger because you have to play over and over and over, and some, you know, sport or some musical instrument, that the guitar, that it's very painful, and so on. And you tell yourself, I don't want to go through that. You don't know that somewhere down the road, that particular skill will take you someplace, right? And so in the very same way, God is saying, I want you to grow. I want you to mature. Why, God? Why is this happening to me? Why did you allow this to happen to me? I want you to mature. So there are two things up to now that we spoke about. And the first one is, I want you to trust me. I want you to trust me. My ways are perfect. I know what I'm doing in your life. Mm. And the second one, he says, that experience will mature you. Because many of the tools and keys that we use now in terms of ministry and counsel, a lot of them came out of
resistance.
Yeah, our own personal experience. And the thing with us is that we are telling you. You know, just the other day, I'm preparing for the engagement I have with Dr. Bellamy in the morning, and I'm just looking over common mistakes that women made. I haven't looked at it for a while, and I'm reading the foreword that Patrice wrote. And in that foreword, she was saying how much she admires me for bearing myself, sometimes to the detriment of me, because you face all kinds of criticisms and things. But I am bearing myself because I grew out of those experiences.
That's it.
And so now it's behind me. And I believe if I could help one person to understand that what you're going through is a necessary step to where God wants to take you and allow you, comfort you at least in the experience until it's time for you to come out, then I would have done something good. And so that's why we continue to be ourselves tell our stories.
And that's why one scripture says, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. And the word temptation, they talks about trials, situations that want to knock you out of the water, like a storm tries to knock out a ship, a tempest knock out a ship. Mm-hmm. But remember, even when there's failure, God is seeing your future, and he's going to use what you think is debris from your future, from your past, to build your future. The devil, on the other hand, he gonna want to use that to stop you from fulfilling it. And always remember, there are three forces that we're fighting all the time. God, the kingdom of God, the kingdom of Satan, and this. The kingdom of Vivian, the kingdom of Joan, the kingdom of
spirit.
And I can tell you, we could, knock out the devil's spirit, the evil spirit. We could resist God well, and many of us are where we are because we resisted God. But you see, the human spirit, until we bring that under control, that's what runs the show, you know, even in God's kingdom.
Praise the Lord.
And we always have to be that song, I surrender all, really.
And to keep surrendering over and over.
Yeah, over and over and over.
So one version says, count it all joy, my brothers.
Right.
When you meet trials of various kinds.
That's the verse, yes.
For you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness.
Mm-hmm.
And the steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be complete and perfect, lacking nothing. And the comment is, God at times allows us to go through hardships to grow our character.
That is one of the people who ask in God for patience and don't realize is the trial of your faith.
Look at patience. Well, I learned that late.
We stop doing that.
Yeah, I don't say, Lord, give me patience, not really. And the King James Version uses the word patience.
Mm-hmm.
But in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, it says, run with patience. And it talks about endurance, perseverance, expectantly waiting. In other words, you are in a situation, stop asking God why.
That's the truth.
Run it with patience. And there are times
when
you can't run, but you can walk. For example, you're on a marathon, and there are some people, you reach a stage where you can't run anymore, but you're walking.
Mm-hmm.
And there are times when you have to will one foot to go in front of the other and go ahead. You may find yourself in a situation like that, and you're wondering, why is it so difficult? Why is it so trying? Mm-hmm. Why is it so painful? And just ask God for the strength, Holy Spirit for the strength, to put one foot in front of the other. Hallelujah. One day at a time, Lord Jesus. One day at a time. And if the day seems too hard, say, give me a minute at a time, an hour at a time, cut it down shorter. If I could get through this hour, I'll deal with the next. And I remember sharing with somebody who got some terrible news out of the blue. I mean, I don't know the level of their relationship and so on. Was married, and the husband went out to work. He would work out of the island for some time. And then one time he came in and decided to visit her in the workplace. And when she thought was, a visit, a surprise, he brought divorce papers. And she said, she took those papers in her hand and she said, go on. If you're going to only let me get through today, that's all I'm asking you. I'm not thinking about tomorrow. I'm not thinking about the consequences, just today.
Mm-hmm.
And she took the papers, she folded it up, she went back and she worked for the day. And she said, every morning I got up and I went to work. People didn't even know that she was just hit with a Mack truck. And she would say, God, Holy Spirit, just give me grace for one day. So many of you have asked the question, you know, how can I learn to understand the Bible? How will I grasp it? I embrace the Bible as a whole, but still, when I read, I find great difficulty, challenges in understanding. Even when the sermons are preached, I still find that I cannot follow the pastor as I would like to. Well, if you feel that way, I just want to give you a little heads up. The promo will come out at some point. That School of the Bible 2023, a registration will be open for you. You can call in anytime, 633-3780, and inquire about School of the Bible. In a nutshell, School of the Bible is a program for regular people in the pews, in the benches, who just want to understand the Bible better. For 2023, we offer three tracks. We call them All in Track, where you have to do all the work. You have assignments, you have assessments, you have book reports, and whatever is involved, you have to do everything. We have the auditing track, where you don't do assessments and assignments. You have everything else to do. And the final track is the auxiliary track, where you only do a pre-test and a post-test. When you call us, 633-3780, we're going to give you all the details. And if you're really serious about
being a part of it, we will send you a brochure with the information and answer any of the questions that you may have. You may contact us at 633-3780 for further information on SOTB or SOTB@ddwc.net. SOTB@ddwc.net. Forget what Jesus said. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me.